Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. My name is Brianna. If you're new, I upload new videos every Sunday and Wednesday. So let me just start off by saying that I know it's been a while since I posted a video related to substitute teaching, education, teaching in general. That is because of COVID-19. I have not been to work since March. So it's been about 5 months now because my school closed due to COVID. So obviously I didn't really have a lot of content to make, but there have been a lot of updates since then. I actually have accepted my first position as a teacher, and as of today when I'm filming, today is July 6th. Not sure when you guys will see this, but in 1 month from today, on August 6th of 2020, I begin my journey as a first year teacher. So long story short, this video is going to be about how I am becoming a certified teacher here in Texas. I am not yet fully certified, and I get this question a lot in the comments. So let me just say this video might be a little bit long because there's a lot to cover, but I will have timestamps down below if there's something specific you're looking for. So I'm going to be talking about my journey, why I wanted to become a teacher, and what I've done so far and what I still have to do to be a fully certified teacher. So if you want to see that, then keep watching. So also, just a quick side note is that I am in the state of Texas. So each state kind of has their own way of becoming a teacher. There's different requirements and different programs, and this video is me talking about my experience in Texas. However, this probably could apply to different states. There are similar programs. I'll do research and find a few other programs in some other common states, but this video is specifically about Texas. So when becoming a teacher, there are kind of two main routes. There's the traditional route of going to a four-year college, getting your bachelor's degree in studying education. You'll take classes, learn about all the different things that have to do with being a teacher, and then in your final semester of college, you'll do a semester, sometimes a whole year, of student teaching. You'll take your exams, your certifications, depending on what state you're in, and then you'll apply for a job and become a teacher. That is not the route that I took. So the second route that you can take to become a teacher is typically called alternative certification, and that basically means that you did not go to college to be a teacher and you're doing a career change. So for me, I got my bachelor's degree in 2018 from UT Austin Hook 'em Horns in journalism. And the entire time I was going to school there, I did not change majors. It's pretty common for people to change majors in college because, let's be real, when you're filling out classes and picking a major at 18 or 19 years old, you do not know what you want to do for the rest of your life. And that's perfectly fine because most people don't. So it is pretty common for people to change majors a couple of times, but I stuck to that same major for all 4 years, and I really thought that I wanted to be a reporter. I had tons of internships working at newspapers, online media, things like that, and after graduation for a year, I did a fellowship as a reporter. And so I really thought that I was going to work in the field that I got my degree in, but during that year of my fellowship, it just really didn't feel like what I wanted to do, and life is too short to be in a career or be in a job that you feel miserable in, especially if you spent a lot of money and time getting educated and going to college. There's no point in sticking to a career just because that's what your degree is in. So I decided to stop being a journalist, and I basically just started back from square one. So at that time, I was still living in Austin, Texas, which is where I got my degree from. And so I decided to end my fellowship early and move back home and figure out what I wanted to do. So I honestly had no clue what I wanted to do. I had spent all of my 4 years studying journalism and newspapers and digital media, and had pretty much put all of my effort into that. My resume was filled with things that had to do with journalism. And with a bachelor's degree, it does open up a lot of doors. You can apply for jobs that don't have to do with that specific career field, but I had no clue what I wanted to do, and I was really looking for a job that I would feel excited and happy to go to and just have an overall fulfilling career. So while I was at home, I obviously needed a job because I still had bills to pay, and even though I was living at home rent free and didn't have anything like rent or utilities, water bills, stuff like that, I still had other bills like student loans, credit cards, and just other random things like that. So I did have to get a job while I was figuring out what to do. I started applying to some places like restaurants and fast food and stuff like that, but I just, at that point, at 23 years old with a bachelor's degree, I just really did not feel like going back to those types of jobs. Not that there's anything wrong with working those types of jobs, but throughout high school and college, I had worked so many of those food industry and service retail jobs, and I just really didn't feel like having that type of job again. And so my cousin that also lived in the area had been a first grade teacher, and she suggested that I maybe try substitute teaching in the meantime just to make some money where I'm looking for a longer term position or a career change. So after that, I became a sub, and I have an entire playlist about my experience, how I became a sub, all that stuff on my channel that I'll link down below. I'm not going to get into that in this video, but basically while I started subbing, I realized that this was a career field that I wanted to do. It felt great to work with kids. Every single day was different. There was a lot of movement. One of the things that I really hated about my position as a journalist is that I was often sitting at my desk in the office, and I really just wanted to have a job where I was moving around and just doing more instead of being in one place. There were times where I would get sent to go to different places to cover events and stuff like that, but for the most part of my 40-hour work week, I was sitting at my desk on my laptop. So, like, you know if it feels like it's the right career for you. I love working with kids. Even though they are very stressful, every single day was a different day. I loved going to different schools, seeing different kids of different ages, talking to teachers, being able to impact the future generations. Just the whole thing of being a sub made me realize that I wanted to be a teacher. So that was a really long intro for me getting into why I wanted to be a teacher. And I just really felt actually excited to go to work every day to have these conversations with kids, help them with their problems, both curriculum related and just in life in general. And I just love the environment of being in a school. So after I decided that I wanted to switch careers to be a teacher, next was finding out what to do. So in the state of Texas, there are programs called ACPs, or alternative certification programs, for people like me who got a four-year college degree in something else and decided to be a teacher. So in Texas, and I believe in probably all the 50 states in America, you have to have a four-year degree or a bachelor's degree to be a teacher. So if you're watching this and you do not currently have that, then keep working on your education, or if you haven't started, find a college. I would suggest going to community college, knocking out your basics, and then going to a four-year university to get that bachelor's degree, because you cannot even do these programs until you have that degree. So in Texas, there are a lot of different ACP programs. Let me just Google a few to name a couple of them. So in Texas, some of the top five most popular are iTeach Texas, eTools for Education, Inspire Texas, ECAP, and the one that I did is Texas Teachers of Tomorrow. So I kind of did a bit of research online, and from what I saw, the most popular one was this one, Texas Teachers of Tomorrow. So I went on their website and did a ton of research. I read all of the things on their website and just got the full picture of what I was signing up to do. So there was another option, is that I could have gone back to college, taken a couple of classes to get certified to teach, but in the long run, that would have been more expensive and taken a lot longer, and my goal was to get in the classroom and get my certification as soon as possible. So if you see me looking down, I'm just trying to make sure I get all this info correct, and this is what I did to sign up for the Texas Teachers of Tomorrow. So for Texas Teachers of Tomorrow, it's free to apply online. You just need info about yourself and your college transcript, and then after you are accepted, it costs $330 for the enrollment fee. I think online it says $295, but they did throw in like a $30 technology fee, so the total was around like $325 or $330. So the thing about this program is that it is completely online except for a small part I'll talk about later, and it's 100% self-paced. So if you have children, if you have a part-time job, a full-time job, whatever you're doing, it's all on you to do it. It's all online and it's all self-paced. You can sit down, put your head down, and finish in 2 months, or it can take you 6 months or take you a year. It really just depends on your goals, your timeline, and what you have time to do. So the program has, you have a bunch of online classes that's kind of like a fast-paced version of what you would have learned if you studied education in college. So I'll go through some of the different classes I had to take. I think the total number of hours of all the courses online was about 120 hours. So there is a lot of classes. There's quizzes at the end to make sure that you are knowledgeable and you cannot move on until you pass those quizzes. So after the training portion or the online courses, you do have to do 30 hours of observations, which is just you observing a full-time certified teacher to see how they run their classroom management, their teaching, all of that stuff. And then after that, you move on to your certification exams. So that was a lot. Let me rewind and talk about some of the online courses. So the system that Texas Teachers uses is Canvas. I use that in college, and I think now some people even use it in high school. It's basically just like Blackboard that has all of your courses and classes online. If you've never used it before, it's pretty self-explanatory and pretty user-friendly. Okay, so let me just read off some of the titles of some of the different courses that I took. So for me, I knew that I wanted to do secondary, which is middle and high school. So some of the courses are geared specifically towards that, but some of them are just teaching in general. So some of the classes were techniques of classroom management, teaching in a diverse classroom, developing a respectful learning environment, formal assessment, reading for the secondary teacher, teaching strategies that work, understanding the TEKS, which is basically just the Texas system of what they have to learn, and mental health was one I had to take, preparing for the profession, collaboration, communication. So there's a whole bunch of different courses that you have to take. So I started in May, and it took me all the way until September, the end of August, to finish the courses. Honestly, I was being kind of lazy, and I definitely could have finished a lot quicker, but it took me about 4 months to finish all of those courses. So the next step after that was getting observation hours. So COVID-19 has kind of changed some of the requirements, but for me, when I did it, I had to do 30 hours total of classroom observations, but I did have the option of doing 15 of them online. So online from the Texas Teacher Portal, they have a bunch of videos that you watch of different teachers, and you just have to clock in 15 hours. So I did 15 online and then 15 in person, and I actually observed my cousin, who is the first grade teacher. So I spent 2 full days with her from the very beginning to the very end to get my 15 hours. It was a long day, and it definitely made me realize that I did not want to do elementary school teachers. Props to you guys, but it just didn't feel like the thing for me. So after I did all that, they had to get approved by Texas Teachers Up tomorrow, and then after that, I was ready to take my content exam. So in the state of Texas, and probably in most states, whatever you want to teach, you have to prove that you are knowledgeable in that area, and you have to pass a content exam for that specific area. So it depends on the level that you're teaching, because as you guys know, like in elementary school, you're teaching math, science, reading, you're teaching everything. But once you get up to middle school and high school, it's more specific, like you're teaching a specific history class or English or something that's more narrowed down. So for me, I knew that I wanted to do English, and so my test for English was secondary English grades 7 through 12. Another test that I took is the ESL test. So if you are specifically in Texas, a lot of schools require or prefer that if you teach English, you also are certified in ESL, because Texas has a large portion of kids who do not speak English. A lot of kids speak Spanish, and basically learning that ESL portion just teaches you how to teach kids who their first language is not English. And so that was my second test. And then third, I got certified for secondary journalism, which is grades 7 through 12. I got my degree in it, so I figured why not just get that test out of the way, just to make me more marketable. The more that you're able to offer a school, the more likely they are to hire you. If you can only teach one thing, that really kind of narrows where they can put you. But if you have 2 or 3, even 4 different areas that you can teach, you're more likely to get hired, because they have different places they can put you and use you for different classes. Okay, so now let's talk about the exams. So honestly, I have always not been a fan of standardized testing, because I just don't think it shows the whole picture, and it does not prove who you are as a student or as a teacher or anybody from these tests. However, you have to do what you have to do, and in Texas, you need to pass these content exams. So let me just say that you have to study. I went in thinking that these exams would be easy. I went to one of the top universities in Texas. I had a very hard time going through college from how tough my curriculum was, and I thought they were gonna be a breeze. No, these tests are not easy. They're made to be challenging. They're long, like 4 or 5 hour long tests with essays and multiple choice and just a whole bunch going going on, so you have to study. You will spend a lot of money studying and a lot of money taking these tests. If you fail, it will cost you more money. So each test costs about $118. I took 3 tests and I'll talk about how I failed one. So I ended up paying for 4 tests, $118. How much money did I spend? 118 times 4 is 472. I spent almost $500 on these tests. On top of buying study guides, I probably spent at least $600 on these tests. They are not cheap and you do not want to be like me and fail a test, so you have to study. So whatever tests you're taking, find a study guide online, buy that study guide and use it. So for me, I bought a study guide for English and for journalism, and for ESL, my cousin had actually just taken that exam, so she let me have hers. If you have friends who are teachers, ask them, try to buy a used book, do whatever you can, but you have to study with a guide or some type of material. You cannot just remember what you were taught in high school or college and think you're going to ace that exam. These exams are tough and you definitely have to study. So I definitely will make videos about how I specifically studied for each of my 3 exams, because this video will be so long if I talk about all of those. But basically, I was offered a job contingent upon me passing my English exam. So I had already taken my English exam and was waiting to get my results, and I interviewed and got hired at my first ever job, or at least what I thought would be my first ever job. And actually, the day after I accepted that position, I got my results back and I had failed my exam by about 1 question. So after that, I lost that job position and I had to retake that exam, and it was a long process of restudying and building up the confidence to go back in and take that test again. It took me a lot longer than I would have liked it to do, but finally this year, as of March this year, I officially passed all of my exams. In Texas, from what I experienced, most schools do not even want to interview you or pay you any type of attention unless you have those past results. Some schools will not even let you apply unless you are a fully certified teacher. They don't care if you're going through this program, you have to be fully certified. So, after you pass those exams, then you are able to start applying for jobs. Applying for jobs is a very long and tedious process, and you have to find schools that are willing to hire you and that they know you're doing an ACP program. Lots of schools don't care, but there are certain school districts that do not like to hire people who are in ACP, so they prefer to have a more experienced teacher. So once I had all of those 3 exams passed, I started applying to jobs all over. With your first job, especially doing an ACP, you cannot be picky. Apply to jobs all over. I kind of set like maybe like a 20-mile radius around where I lived and applied to every single English, journalism, or ESL job from grades 7 through 12. I knew that I wanted to do high school, but I honestly just applied to grades 7 and 8 just to kind of just get my application out there, because hiring season is so crucial. Also, if you're applying to jobs for the whole new school year, right around spring, May, April is when college students are graduating. So there's tons of people in the job pool, so you really just have to not be picky and apply to everywhere. So I will make a whole video detailing how I made my resume, but after that I basically just started applying to every single job I could find and going to as many job fairs as possible. Whenever you are applying or going to job fairs doing interviews, just be transparent and tell them that you are doing an ACP program, tell them all the exams that you've passed, and kind of just let them know about the entire process. Most jobs, again, will not care, but there are some schools who might not want to hire you because of that. Okay, so after you are offered a job, the next step is to accept that job, fill out your contract with that school district, and then you have to go through the process of telling your program where you're working, what grades you're teaching, your supervisor, all that stuff. And after they check to make sure that you actually did get that job and you are hired, they will approve you. And the next step is teaching. So the way this program works is you basically do all of your coursework, your classes, your observations, your content exams, and then you teach for 1 full school year. So that school year is your intern year, and you are given a probationary certification, meaning you are not fully certified, but you are able to be the sole teacher of that classroom. The program gives you a mentor to kind of help you along and kind of make sure that you're actually teaching like you should be. You also usually will get a mentor teacher from your school just because you are a first year teacher. So within that full year, at the end of that year, you take your PPR, which is the Texas exam for pedagogy and professional responsibilities, basically an exam about how to be a teacher. After you pass that and you finish your full year of teaching, you're all good to go. Your program recommends you to the state of Texas to get your final teacher certification. Yes, that also costs money. Let's see how much that costs. All in all, it is expensive. So after that, you are officially a certified teacher and you can apply to jobs anywhere, and you can work without having any classes or projects or a mentor from your program, and you are done with the program. Last part is there is a program fee. So Texas Teachers of Tomorrow costs about $4,500, which is kind of like a semester of college, but you don't pay until you start working. So once you start working, they will automatically take out that money from your paycheck for 12 months and then you're done with the program. The total fee is, for me, the total fee is $4,350. So once I start working, they'll divide that up by 12 months. And so my monthly payment will be $4,350 divided by 12. My monthly payment will be about $362. And after 12 months, I'll be done with the program. So it definitely is not cheap to become a teacher, but in the long run, it will be worth it to have a career that you actually enjoy doing. So I know this video was pretty vague, but that's just an overview of how I am becoming a teacher. So right now I have accepted my job and I'm pretty much just waiting to start. I could not have picked a more strange time to become a teacher with COVID-19 and everything going on. Honestly, right now I'm not really sure how my school year is going to look, but I'm just going in with a really positive attitude. I'm so excited to meet my kids and be a teacher, even though I'm so nervous. I definitely am going to be confident and just enjoy every step of the way, both good and bad. So in 1 month I start my contract and my school starts on August 17th, so about 5 or 6 weeks before I'm actually in the classroom with kids. And then after that, I'll be working on doing my projects, studying for my PPR, and in 1 year I will be a full teacher in Texas. So I hope that answered some of your questions. I get this question all the time about how I am becoming a teacher, and all in all, I would say that Texas Teachers of Tomorrow is a great program. They have great customer service. The website and everything is very simple and easy to use, and the price is similar to all the other programs. They all will cost you around $3,000, $4,000, or $5,000, which is similar to a semester of college. So I will make more detailed videos about things like making my resume, studying for the exams, interviewing. That was the whole thing itself, so stay tuned for those. But that is how I am doing my ACP program to become a teacher. So this fall I will be teaching 9th grade English. Yes, I have the freshmen and I'm so excited to do that. So right now I'm in the process of just waiting for the school year to start to see what will happen. I've been gathering up supplies and decorations, vlogs coming soon of me decorating my classroom. I hope I have a classroom. Pretty sure I will. But I've been doing some small DIY projects and just getting together supplies like the typical stapler, pencils, pens, highlighters, all that stuff. So this video is probably very long, but thank you guys for watching if you stayed till this long. Make sure that you are subscribed down below for new uploads every Sunday and Wednesday, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye y'all.